wrong. We didn't know what we had until it was gone.
For example, I'm guessing you probably know what is the Amazon Desert, right? Well, believe it or not, it was once called the Amazon Rainforest. And there were billions of trees there. And all of them gorgeous and just, oh, you don't know much about trees, do you? Well, let me tell you, the trees are amazing. And I mean, we literally breathe the air. They are creating, they clean up our pollution, our carbon, store, and purify water. The medicines that cures our diseases and the food that feed us. Which is why I am so sorry to tell that we burned them down. Cut them down with our brutal machines? Horrific! At the rate of 40 football fields every minute. That's 50% of all the trees in the world. All gone in the last 100 years. Why? For this. And that wouldn't make me so sad if there weren't so many pictures of leaves on it. You know, when I was a child, I read how Native Americans had such consideration for the planet that they have felt responsible for how they have left the land in the next 7 generations. Which brings me great sorrow, because most of us today don't even care about tomorrow. So I'm sorry. I'm sorry that we use profit over people, greed over need, the rule of gold above the golden rule. I'm sorry that we use nature as a credit card without no spending limit, overdrafting animals to extinction, stealing your chance to oversee their uniqueness or even become friends with them. I'm sorry we poison oceans so much that you cannot even swim in them. But most of all, I'm sorry about our mindset, because we have the nerve to call for this destruction progress. Hey Fox News, if you don't think that the climate change is a threat, when I dare you to interview 1,000 homeless of people in Bangladesh, see? While you was in your penthouse nest held, their homes were literally washed away beneath their feet due to the rising sea level. And Sarah Palin, you said that you love the smell of the fossil fuels. Well, I urge you to talk to the kids of Beijing who are forced to wear pollution masks just to go to school. You see? You can't ignore this. But the thing about the truth is, it can be denied, not avoided. So I'm sorry, future generations. I'm sorry that our footprints became a sinkhole and not a garden. I'm sorry that we paid so much attention to ISIS and very little how fast the ice is melting in our lake. I'm sorry we don't use. And I'm sorry we didn't find another planet in time to move to. I'm so... You know what? God, Bobby, I'm not sorry. This future, I do not accept it. Because an error does not become a mistake until you refuse to correct it. We can redirect this. How? Well, let me suggest that if a farmer sees a tree that isn't healthy, they do not look at the branches to diagnose it. They look at the roots. So like farmers, we must look at the roots and not to the branches of the government. Not to the politician run by a corporation. We are the roots. We are the foundation. This generation, it is up to us to take care of this planet. It is our only hope. We must globally warm our hearts and change the climate of our soul and realize that we are not a part of nature. We are part of the nature. And to betray nature is to betray us. And to save nature is to save us. Because whatever you're fighting for,
racism, poverty, feminism, gay rights, and any type of equality, it won't matter in the list. Because if we don't work all together to save our environment, we will be equal extinct. Sorry. Dear future generations, sorry. By Prince E.A.